guys, I'm Bailey. Thank you for clicking on my channel. Today will be part one of a series that I'm doing on natural childbirth, and I'm really, really excited about this series because over the course of my pregnancy, I became so incredibly passionate about natural childbirth, and I really want to share that with you. So if you're interested in finding out exactly why I decided to have a natural childbirth, then just keep watching.
Dreaming of the days when you were in my arms, I never felt so alive. I spent my days working, spent my nights drinking, howling at the moon.
Okay, so I still remember the first night that I was pregnant. I could not sleep because I kept thinking, oh my gosh, this baby has to come out of me. Like, how am I gonna birth this baby? How am I gonna go through labor and delivery? I'm so scared, and I feel like that's such a natural way to feel. So I began to immediately start doing research about labor and delivery and birthing your baby, and the more research I did and the more educated I became, the more comfortable I also became with the idea of birthing a baby. I read at least 5 books throughout my pregnancy. My husband and I enrolled in 2 courses. One was 12 weeks and one was 6 weeks. And then my husband also read a book, so he was prepared as well. So what I would like to do in this series is share all of that research with you. Basically, I want to summarize each book in a video that I read so you can choose which books you're interested in finding out about, and I will summarize the courses that I took. So I didn't hire a doula. My husband basically was trained, in a sense, to be my doula, and so he did an amazing job with that. And you can use, you know, your birth partner, or you can have a parent or someone that you feel really close and comfortable around to be your birth partner. And it's just really nice to have someone there on your side that knows exactly what you want, that can vouch for you, be there to support you. So that's really important. And I think I'll have Chris summarize that chapter, and he'll do a video all about it. So I'll have him do that video about being a birth partner. But this series will basically encompass everything that I learned throughout my entire pregnancy so that I was able to make an informed decision that worked best for me personally. So you can pick and choose what you're interested in learning more about, if you're pregnant, or whether, you know, you're thinking about getting pregnant, or you're starting to live a more natural lifestyle and you want to try to have a natural childbirth, then I encourage you to keep watching this series because, like I said, I did completely educate myself throughout my whole pregnancy in order to prepare. I would like to mention that I am not a healthcare professional, I'm not an obstetrician, I'm not a doctor, a midwife, or a doula. I'm just a parent who has been pregnant once and who has had a natural childbirth once. I would also like to say that just because I decided for myself to have a natural childbirth, it doesn't mean that I think any less of anybody who has had a different birth experience. Whether you've had a cesarean section, whether you've had an epidural, whether you planned a natural childbirth and it didn't go the same way for you, or you had complications or anything like that, honestly, you are amazing. All women are so incredible. It makes me emotional to talk about because you house these babies for so long, you nurse them, and then you bring them into the world in some way. And no matter how you bring that baby into the world, as long as that baby is healthy and happy and safe, then that is the number one priority. But after doing a lot of research, I really thought that natural childbirth was best for me and best for my baby. And he is such a calm, content baby, and I honestly, truly believe that because he had such a peaceful bringing into this world, it's made him a calmer individual. And if you do any research on birth psychology, then you'll probably agree with me on that. And actually, I might do a video summarizing some birth psychology that I read about too, so I'll talk about that. So why did I decide to have a natural childbirth? Well, we aren't sick. We don't need to be in a hospital hooked up to all these machines, not being able to walk or move or feel our legs or feel parts of our body. Like I said, we're not sick. We're having a baby. And so many women do it every single day, and we've been doing it for generations and generations, and it is one of the most natural things. So let me start by talking about one of the first methods of intervention, and that would be induction. So I made an induction date at the hospital 15 days after my due date, which I was so upset about. I thought that making an induction date was me basically like putting into the universe that I was going to have to be induced. In the meantime, I did a lot of different natural ways to induce my labor in hopes that I wouldn't have to be induced. If I were to be induced in the hospital, they often would start with Cervidil, which is a cream that they use to ripen your cervix and get labor moving. Something that's a lot more intense is Pitocin. Pitocin is basically a synthetic form of oxytocin, and what it does is it starts contractions. Now, they'll give you a dosage based on what they think is best for you, but they'll often have to turn it up to get the contractions going. Artificial contractions created by Pitocin are not the same as natural contractions. Basically, Pitocin contractions are a lot more painful, a lot closer together, and they're sudden because they are created through an external source and not through your natural hormones. A lot of moms who have had Pitocin and been induced via Pitocin have had extremely painful contractions that they're not able to breathe through and they're not able to labor through. And so for that reason, they then in turn request an epidural to deal with the pain. Once an epidural has been requested, you wait for the anesthesiologist to inject it into your back, and you need to stay really, really still when that is occurring. They are putting it into your spine. I was worried that I could move a little bit. You know, they do it when you're having a contraction, or maybe the needle would shift just the slightest amount. I've heard a lot of moms say that they had an epidural and then they had back pain after for quite some time. And that is something that I really wanted to avoid. I was really worried about potentially having back pain. Also, you're not feeling any pain, but your baby is going through the most traumatic event of his or her entire life. When the baby is going through the birth canal, there are more stress hormones released than there ever will be in your whole entire life. An epidural can cause laboring mothers to develop a fever, and babies born to feverish mothers have been shown to have lower Apgar scores and lowered immune systems. An epidural often will raise the laboring mother's blood pressure, which depresses the heart rate of the baby in utero and can lead to an emergency C-section in very rare cases, but in most cases it does cause issues with the baby's heart rate. An epidural does lengthen the time that you're in the second stage of labor. Our bodies are amazing. Our hormones know what to do when we go into labor. So basically, oxytocin is released, which triggers contractions to occur, which also releases endorphins, which makes us feel happy and excited. But any forms of hormones that aren't created by our body, whether it be Pitocin or narcotics, do interfere with that wonderful cascade of hormones, so you no longer get those endorphins released, you no longer get the oxytocin that's being released, and everything that's happening in your body now becomes completely 100% reliant on drugs. Another reason why I chose not to get an epidural was because I wanted the ability to move freely. I wanted to birth my baby however I wanted to, in whatever position I wanted to. So a lot of times, doctors will have you lay on your back with your legs up and bent so that you can push the baby out. And that is not an ideal position for having a baby. It's an ideal position for a doctor because they can see, they can sit on a stool and they can see exactly what's going on. But it's not an ideal position for gravity and bringing your baby into the world. I really wanted to be on my hands and knees or in a squatting position, or in some sort of upright position so that gravity would help move my baby down. Because really, when you're laying on your back, you're working against gravity. Also, when you're laying on your back, there's a lot of pressure towards your rectum, and that's where tearing can occur between your vagina and your rectum. And so if you think about it, you're pushing a baby out, and all of that pressure is on the back side, and it could likely cause a lot worse tearing than in another position. Tearing can actually cause more complications down the road, such as incontinence, sexual dysfunction, pelvic floor weakness, and things like that. Another reason why I chose not to get an epidural was because I didn't want a catheter. I know a lot of times when you get an epidural, your legs are numb, so you can't walk to the bathroom, and for that reason, they use another form of intervention, which is a catheter. Now, a catheter can be painful. I mean, you don't feel it going in, but when they do remove it, you can feel it a lot of times because you're no longer under an anesthetic. And also, it's really important that you make sure that you urinate a certain amount after you've put the catheter in and once it's been removed, because they need to make sure your bladder is empty or it could cause infection. Another reason why I opted not to get an epidural was because I did not want a cesarean section. Mostly because of the recovery afterwards. So, I mean, to all you mamas who have had a C-section, an emergency C-section, you didn't plan one and you ended up having one anyways, you're amazing. And I just was afraid of the recovery after. I was afraid of not being able to carry my baby or lift things, or the pain that I would feel when I was nursing my baby and he was rubbing up on my incision. Another reason I didn't want a C-section was because I always pictured that moment when the baby finally came out and I was just so excited and happy and my husband and I both held him in our arms. And another reason why I didn't want a C-section is because passing through the birth canal is actually really, really good for the baby. It helps shape the baby's head and it helps expel amniotic fluid from the baby's lungs. Vaginally born babies have been shown to have more diversified microbiomes as well as less allergies, and when they do pass through the birth canal, they receive protective bacteria that helps build their immune system right from the get-go. The pain that a woman feels in childbirth is actually really efficient and is there for a reason. It guides the woman, it shows her, you know, maybe I should switch positions, maybe I should try something else, or, oh, I'm getting the pushing sensation, that expulsive reflex that's happening to get the baby out, and I'm going to go along with that expulsive reflex. I'm going to, you know, follow what my body is doing because I can feel exactly what my body needs. I can feel my baby moving down. I can feel my cervix ripening. Everything like that that occurs is supposed to occur for the baby to come in a healthy, happy way. And so to interfere with that pain, that feeling, triggers a less responsive state, and your body isn't in tune with your mind, you're not sure what's going on, you can't feel the pushing reflex when it happens, and it's a lot harder to push when you can't feel your legs. I read a study that talked about women who are completely able to birth their babies when they're in comas. So if that doesn't tell you that our bodies are capable of this, then I don't know what does. You can do this. You can birth your baby. Your body knows what to do. You have to have faith in your body's ability. You have to know and be confident. So anyways, that's all I'm going to talk about in today's video. So thank you. What's wrong, my baby? He wants some lovin'. I better go. Okay. So anyways, guys, thank you so much for clicking on my channel, watching my video. If you stuck through it to the end and you liked it, then click the like button and subscribe for more. And if you're interested in seeing more about the natural childbirth videos, or there was something that I said that you thought that you didn't agree with, or you did agree with, let me know in the comments below. So again, thanks guys, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye!